One.
Hi everybody, I'm Debbie with Rocky Mountain Lodge, and this is my granddaughter Hannah, who asked about 5 minutes ago if she could help with the video today. And of course I have to say yes, and so she's going to be my little helper today. And so today we are going to be making mini phyllo quiches, which are a super easy, fast, quick appetizer that are great for bridal showers, holiday appetizers, tapas, anything like that. Tea parties. We had these at our mother-daughter tea party, didn't we?
Yeah.
Did you like them?
Yes.
Are you going to eat some today? Of course. Okay. So this recipe you can find on our website, rockymountainlodge.com, and you can click on the recipes tab and find this recipe there. You can also purchase our cookbook, Rocky Mountain Lodge and Cabin's More Favorite Recipes. This cookbook has 500 recipes in it and also includes a free ebook version. And right now, everything in my gift shop is half price. So this cookbook is $10. And you can go to that, you can find this on the gift shop tab on our website, and then you can get 500 recipes. All right, so there is that. I'll set that aside for now. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna have Hannah start by making the filling for our quiches. So Hannah, we're gonna put in, I'm actually just doing a half batch right here because I already did the other half batch a little bit before this video, so I have a finished product to show you, but I'm gonna tell you what the full recipe is. So the full recipe is 2 eggs. You wanna pour that in a bowl? Okay. And then we have 1/2 cup of evaporated milk. Thank you. And here, I just put everything together into one little bowl to condense it. We have 1/4 teaspoon of salt, 1/4 teaspoon of granulated garlic, 1/4 teaspoon of finely chopped fresh parsley, 1/8 teaspoon of white pepper. If you don't have white pepper, it's okay, you can use black pepper. And then 1/4 teaspoon of finely chopped fresh basil, and that's it. And so Hannah's gonna put all of those in there right now. Just pour those all in there. They're sticking. It's kind of humid here today, so let me scrape those out. Yeah, that's all right. Okay, so Hannah is gonna mix all of these together right now while I tell you about the rest of the ingredients. So she's gonna do a great job mixing those. And so what you're gonna have now is you're gonna have 2 of these packages of phyllo shells. And so they just come pre-packaged like this. I kind of actually started mine already a little bit just to take a shortcut here. But they just look like this when they come out of the box. So you're gonna want 2 boxes, and there's 15 shells per box. They're just little tiny bite-sized phyllo shells. And this is Swiss cheese. You're gonna need 1/2 cup of grated Swiss cheese. And I have actually already done all of these except for this last one, just to save time. Just kind of put it in each one. Okay, so for time's sake, I kind of pre-did those. And then here we have, this is gonna be 2 tablespoons of finely chopped red bell pepper. And I'm just gonna sprinkle this on all of these, just kind of divide it up in between all of these. It's about 1/4 teaspoon per each shell. And if you don't get it exact, it's not a problem. How's that coming along? Oh, you're doing so good. She's a good stirrer. Sometimes it's really nice to have little helpers to do these things. She's my sous chef for today. Do you know what a sous chef is?
No.
It's like a helper chef. So are you my helper chef?
Yeah.
Do you know what a chef is?
No.
It's a cook, a professional cook. Nanny's not really a chef, but I'm a wannabe chef.
And a sous chef is somebody that does what they're told.
They kind of help you and do all your prep work for you. When we were running the bed and breakfast, my husband Brian, who's also talking and filming today, was my sous chef.
I did what I was told.
He did a good job at it. We made a pretty great team when we were running the B&B. We did that for about almost 17 years, or a little over 17 years we ran the B&B. Almost 18 years. And so now, I guess I should tell you what I'm doing next. This is 2 tablespoons of finely chopped and diced green peppers. Green onions. Chives, green onions. So that's what these are. And so we're also putting these in. These come out so pretty when we make them, and I have some done to show you. And then we have 1/3 cup of finely chopped bacon. Be careful with, okay, you're all done? That's perfect, Hannah. So be careful when you're doing these that you don't eat all the bacon when you're crumbling it up. Would you guys eat all the bacon? Do you sneak bacon when mommy makes bacon? No. Does mommy cook bacon or does daddy cook bacon, or do they both?
Daddy.
Daddy does the bacon cooking?
But when he's at work, mama does it.
Okay, mommy does it. So they both cook bacon, yeah.
Do you have a bacon pocket?
No.
You need a bacon pocket.
Say, why do I need a bacon pocket, Pa?
Why do I need a bacon
pocket? Where else will you keep your bacon for later? You have to keep it in a bacon pocket.
Do you save any for later, or do you just eat it all?
I eat it.
Of course, that's the best thing to do. All right, so now we have all of our ingredients in here. And then I'm going to take a little tiny spoon here, a little tiny ladle, and we are going to ladle all of these yummy ingredients that Hannah has been mixing for us into these quiches. And you have to be kind of careful with these so you don't just spill them all outside. You just do small little amounts of this egg mixture. We're just going to put it in here. I have my pan lined with parchment paper, so I just don't make a huge mess on my pan. And then it makes for a really easy cleanup, because then you just throw the parchment paper away and your pan is clean. Hopefully, that's the goal. Man. So we're just ladling all of these in.
Nanny's making a mess.
I am making a mess. I probably should slow down a little bit.
That's all right.
But that's why we have parchment paper. I just get in a little bit of a hurry sometimes. See, if I go very slowly, I do a better job. What was your favorite thing to eat when we had our tea party? This was your favorite thing? Was this better than the cookies? It was. Better than the little carrot cakes?
I like the carrot cakes too.
You did like the mini carrot cakes? Mm-hmm. Maybe we should show them some of our carrot cakes that we have left over from our tea party and how pretty they looked, huh? Should we show them some? All right. So then we're going to put this in a preheated 350-degree oven for 12 to 15 minutes. And you can serve these warm. You can serve them at room temperature. And when they come out of the oven, they will look like this. So you can see what they look like when they're done. Just little baby quiches, just perfectly bite-sized. And so I serve these at our tea parties. And they're great little appetizers. Lovely for a bridal shower. You can make these a little bit ahead of time and serve them at room temperature. But they are definitely delicious. Do you want to try one, Hannah, and tell me how they are?
Yes.
Okay. You try one and tell me what you think. And I'm going to get those little mini carrot cakes that we have left over and show them those. Let's see what they think of those.
How is it?
Good.
You like it? Could you eat a million of them?
No.
What do you mean, no?
How many could you eat?
Probably like
three? And so these are little mini carrot cakes that I made for the tea party too. Just small little bite-sized little baby carrot cakes. Just perfect for...
Does Hannah want one of those?
You want one of those too? All right, you can have one of these. Here we go. I'll set that right there for you. So, these are our little mini phyllo quiches. You can see how quick and easy they are to make. And so they really literally only take about 5 minutes to put together. It did take me about 10 minutes to do all the chopping. Move these over.
Yeah.
Here?
Yeah, okay. Well, close to you.
So,
yeah.
They don't take very long to make. They're really easy and quick, and they fly off the plate. And so come back next week, which is going to be, let's see, Wednesday, what is today? Today's the 7th. So come back next Wednesday, July 14th, and we're going to be making strawberry pretzel salad or strawberry dessert, which is a great refreshing summer dessert. It's called a salad. Sometimes jello salads are called salads. But it's also a great dessert. I also like to serve it at holiday time. The grandkids all love it. Do you remember that strawberry salad? Mm-hmm. You like that? Mm-hmm. Do you remember it? You don't remember it? Okay. All right, so come back next week. It's been great to share these little maybe mini phyllo quiches with you. And we'll see you next week. Remember to visit our website, RockyMountainLodge.com, where you can find this recipe on the recipes tab. And you can get our cookbook at the gift shop. And everything in our gift shop right now is 50% off.
The appetizers tab.
What?
It's the appetizer tab or the recipe tab.
Oh, did I say it?
You said the recipe tab.
It is recipe tab for these.
Oh, for those?
Recipe tab for these. Gift shop tab for these.
Oh, okay.
I don't know.
Got it.
Okay. All right. You guys can all figure it out.
Yeah.
It's been good to have you. Thanks for saying, let me share this day with Hannah. Hannah, you want to say bye?
Bye.
Okay. Bye, everybody.
Bye, guys.